I'm about to fit the gear set now to the transfer case. What I've done is I've got my special tool. I'll measure this up in a minute or two for you because you always keep asking. I've put some of that heavy oil on and I'm now going to put on the tube, the collapsible tube, fit it inside the gears. Then I take my new pin, put that on there. We'll put some rubber grease on there just in case, it might give it a fighting chance. Somebody asked me, said that I should chamfer this edge. Well, there's no point because that goes into the bush first. And besides that, JP's chamfered the bush anyway, so that should be good. So we're about ready. We're about ready to go. We've used everything in the Ashcroft kit except the shims, which were a bit too thin. So we'll save them for another day. Right, here goes. Oh, nobody, you know, whenever it gets to a good bit like this, somebody always turns up. Or phone goes. It'd be Mark from Ontario wanting to know something. Right. The string is just sort of a guide, if you see what I mean. Just helps. Something. I'm just going to run this through the wire brush and polish it up a bit. It's a little bit tight on
it. Let's give this another go. I've just put some light oil on it.
That's better. Now you can see here the pin is being pushed through the front. I think it's just catching on this bolt and these flanged bolts here. So I'm going to tap it back through again. Try and get that bolt out of there. I wonder if this tool will get it out. Gosh, it's tight on that cover. Yeah. Is it tight on that cover? It should go in. Oh, that's it. Didn't have it quite lifted up enough. There she goes. That's better. I'll have to get myself a new hammer because the fiberglassy bits are coming off. Oh, well, that's good. What a bloody mess, eh? Now it's on that O-ring a bit. I'm going to get a soft hammer to tap that in. There. Now, before we forget, we shall put that bolt back in. What did I tell you?
As soon as I get started, somebody comes down and wants to see my heating system. Oh well, I don't mind, I'll talk to him. So, where were we? We've got the shaft through. However, this little keeper plate here that goes on the flat is 180 degrees out. We need to put the bolt through here. How do we do that, Mike? Well, we simply put the nut on. And with a stocket here, we just turn it round. Now, have we got anything to turn it round? We've got every tool imaginable out here. We've got to, oh yeah, what's this here? Where's that now? I'm going to have a guess it's there. Let's see. Now I did put the O-ring in earlier. Where's the flat on that? That needs to go just through a little bit more. I'm going to just junk out the way. I need to tap that shaft through a bit more. What can I use? Aye. Punch. Oh, a bit more. I'll keep doing this until I get it lined up. Right, once we're roughly in the area, like, you know, you can move it around now by using your thumb or whatever, and then with a bit of Loctite on the bolt, tighten him up. Now, what you're going to find is, well, I'll spin it down a bit, that'll be a bit quicker, just a minute. I'll have to find a 10mm. Ah, there we go, I've cut myself off a bit early now. Never mind. Tighten that down to 25. That's all it's going to get. Now, because we've got the collapsible spacer in there, and this is the bit we've got to work out to tighten up now, that shaft will pull through here even more. Because at the moment, let's have a look and see if we can see, the gears are quite loose. What we've got to do, or what we're going to try and do, is put that into neutral and take out any lash in it. I don't know if you can see, let's pull the camera around a bit more. Oops, doesn't seem to want to go that far. Alright, now this is going to be really difficult to do because it takes a lot of torque to pull this down. So I'm going to get my big bar and work it out. Now I'm just going to have a quick look and see what it says in the book. Because there's all different suggestions of how to do this. Yeah, let me have a look for that. Now, on this book here, what they're doing is they're setting, on the both books, they're setting up the resistance, you know, the preload on the intermediary gears by not fitting the first cover, you know, the two covers on this end. Well, I sort of cheated a little bit, and I knocked up a spline, and it comes out like that. You sort of off an old half shaft, I think it is. And put that in and that'll turn it the same. The thing is, they're asking to collapse, take up the preload in here, well, take up the slack, so you can hear it, eh? And then add 1.25 newton meters. Whereas on the old book, they say wrap a cord round it and pull the cord until 5 to 15 pounds is required. Well, I really don't know because, like I said, I don't know what the diameter of this should be. but it feels right. And in the past, I've just tightened them up and see what they feel like. But the thing is, if you over tighten them, you're sort of screwed because you have to start this all over again. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to sort of nip it down until we take up the slack. God, it's hard to fathom out. You know, there's nothing on that. And then a bit more, so there's some resistance on here. I'm just going to do it by hand. I'm sure it'll be right. Ooh, you don't need much. You don't need much at all. You can hear the backlash. That's on the spline there. Yeah, I don't know if I'd be tempted to do any more than that. It feels really nice, you know what I mean? That's the backlash on the low range. Yeah. I think I'll quit while I'm ahead on that. I really do, because just that little bit, just put that nip onto this here, I could feel it. Yep, that's enough. Right, once we're satisfied with that, we're going to put a bead of sealer on the cases. I've already stalked over the nut. Wow, this stuff's hard to get out of the tube. You don't want to try and get any down the threads. This is why I'm doing it like this. Just avoid the threads. And if you put a bead around the inside, and then we get the lid, or the cover, like that. And a little bob, a little space just on there, that's it. The cover, it'll go on either way. Drop the cover on, and ease it around a bit, you know. You'll be surprised how far it'll all squidge out. And then... oh, am I going to have enough in here? Well, what you're supposed to do is put some Loctite on there, but that's kaput. I'll go get a new tube. So with the Loctite on, I'm just going to spin these down a little bit with this gun, just to save a bit of time. A bit stiff that one. And then we'll tighten down the top wrench. You'll see it squidging out, all the sealer. It's It's not a bad thing, but sometimes it looks a bit messy. Now, for those of you who are wondering, I'm going to let that sealer dry and then we'll do a test to see if it's if it's leaking a bit, you know. We'll do a pressure test on it, but I'll show you what we do to clean all this rubbish off here. Once you've finished, you obviously want to make your job nice and tidy, so just get a little wire brush and rub round it. Take all that excess sealer off. You know, the stuff that's squirted out. Not this, we'll let that dry. You know, and it'll make a nice sort of tidy job, won't it? You know, look at that. Looks like Land Rover's done it, doesn't it? Except it's not leaking. So, we'll leave all the sealers to dry. I think that's nice. We're going to leave, like I said, we'll leave it. We're going to check the drain bung. That's a good thing to do. Wait a minute. Because nobody knows when we took this out, if we tighten it back up again. Have we got a 17 key here? No, we've got everything else. Well, it was tight. The plug was tight with the magnet on, but I haven't got any copper washers. So what I'm going to just do is anneal it. Get it nice and hot. And then we're going to leave it and that'll cool down and then we'll put that in. Then we'll test it. We'll clean it all up. Oh God, that looks good.